that inspired him the most about the event is the youth of all.
To see all these young people.
Morning, everybody. Oh, yeah. Start getting old, you gotta start making noises when you sit down. Yesterday, I forgot to hit record on the recorder, so maybe we can remember to do that today. Organization. We're going to talk about organization. Y'all go ahead and throw me your organization tips, because I'm not good at it. Productivity, more so than organization. I want to talk about productivity. So y'all start lining up the productivity hacks and tips and tricks, and I'll tell you why I suck at it. We'll talk about it later. Holly's mic is so close to that camera, it looks like it's part of the screen.
Get away from the busy man's
phone. Happy hump day to you, everybody. Welcome in to another edition, another day of the Thunder Radio Morning Show. Carrying you on to work, school, home from work, wherever it is you're headed on this Wednesday. We're glad that you're with us. As we are in, you're firmly entrenched in year number 5, right? Yeah, something like that. In the middle of year number 5 of the Thunder Radio Morning Show with Josh and Holly, brought to you by Dr. James Van Winkle, our loyal title sponsor. And those guys over there, Dr. Van Winkle's office, or girls, I guess, do a great job of making sure you're taken care of. Dr. Van Winkle as well. Talk to him and his staff about a couple of the treatments that we talk about a lot. Imcella treatments. Solve urinary incontinence. Spring is here, and you're going to be running and playing with the kids, the grandkids, or even if you just got allergies and you sneeze a lot, you're going to want urinary incontinence to be fixed, and you can have it done in-office. It's a simple, non-invasive treatment. Learn more at drvanwinkle.com at 1030 MacArthur Street right here in Manchester. It's non-surgical. It's non-invasive. Matter of fact, if you mention Thunder Radio when you book any non-surgical treatments, you get half off of those. Learn more. drvanwinkle.com. Call up or go by and see them. They're at 931-954-5125 or 1030 MacArthur Street in Manchester. We have a busy show today. As we mentioned, or as I mentioned off camera a minute ago, or off air a minute ago to our camera folks, I want to talk about organization and productivity today. That's going to be a point of emphasis. We're going to dig into that a little bit. Also, we have Wednesday's Worst Criminals. Name that tune. Stupid, silly stat. Your birthdays, I already got a couple on the list. You can call them in at 931-728-1320. Plenty of ways to catch the show. You can listen on the radio, of course, AM 1320. A lot of people are over there. The original, it's the OG right there, the 1320 signal for, 67 years now. 107.9 FM, 106.7 FM worldwide. You can listen on the Manchester Go app live and at thunder1320.com. Click on listen now. You can also watch the show on the Carmine Family Dental Camera Perfect Smile Cams over on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Search for Thunder Radio. So no excuse to miss out on the show. 68 degrees is going to be high today. We're sitting at 36 right now, but it doesn't feel as bad because it's not as cold as it was yesterday morning. But going to be nice today, up around 68, 70. Best day of the week is today, and then tomorrow's looking okay as well. Temperature update brought to you by Wisteria Hill Boutique in downtown Manchester. They have Easter dresses. Like, I know a lot of people are looking for Easter apparel. You got the family pictures, you got the egg hunts, you got the get-togethers, you got the church. Well, they have all of your Easter dress needs at Wisteria Hill Boutique. Go on by and see them at 205 South Woodland Street near downtown Manchester in the Woodland Shopping Plaza. On that note, we need to bring in the better half of the Thunder Radio Morning Show. She settles in across from me, the brains of this operation. the planner, the organizer, the CEO, and president of Coffee County Broadcasting Incorporated. She is the brains, by far the looks. She is the president-elect of the Manchester Chamber of Commerce. She is Holly. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
It's going to be a good one.
Yeah, it is.
Yes, it's going to be a good one. We got a lot to discuss today. My name is Josh, but you can call me Al. How about that? Happy Wednesday, everybody. I don't know why. This song gets me every time.
I love this song.
Just can't help but dance.
We talked to somebody who didn't like this one.
Somebody that didn't like this. Yeah. Y'all can just get out of here.
Bone digger, bone digger.
Sing it, Holly.
What's that even mean?
I don't even know. They're listening to you, though.
Beer belly, beer belly.
Usually I cut into the music after about 45 seconds, but I feel like I'm going to let most of this one play out so I can listen to it. That's okay, isn't it?
You can call me Al.
Let's see. I do want to talk organization today and productivity. I guess we got to do, the show.
Stop. Let's do the show.
We got to do the show. Stop listening to songs. Sorry. Probably a lot of fun for our camera people, so they can't hear the song.
We're just on our phones.
You're just sitting here.
We're pitiful.
It's a bad show. It's a bad show. We'll do better, y'all. We'll do better. That was Mayor Megan Berry's theme song. Are you serious? Or are you joking? Comings and goings, what's happening in and around the Manchester community and whatnot over the next few days. Holly, we are 3 days away from the start of spring break. Kids will be out next week. We probably need to take a week off. Probably.
It's, yeah.
We won't.
We decided to maybe just a couple days. Maybe.
Speak up.
No, I'm talking normal. You just have my.
You're whispering.
I'm no.
Can we turn your headphones down?
Huh?
Now talk.
I'm just talking normal. Yeah. Might as well not even have them.
That sounds better. I feel like just maybe a little bit.
No, you just need to turn my volume up.
I said, I don't go no louder.
You're such a punk. That goes louder. I can see it. Hey, turn my headphones back up. I don't like that.
That's as loud as they were.
I'm
there up. We're off to a good start today.
Turn my headphones up.
That's louder than they were before.
Please turn my headphones up.
They're up.
Nope.
I can't handle it any louder. That's pretty loud.
You're okay. I thought we were going to have a good day.
We started off right here, and I was like,
no, you know.
Yes, Holly. I
could hear the song.
Turn the knobs.
No, you're the worst.
I think maybe your headphones have been turned down is what's happening. Mine are louder.
That's what I'm saying. Just turn mine up.
Is that louder or lower?
It's louder.
Okay. I don't know which way that goes. So now you're fixed. Now is that better?
Why do I have to fight you so hard? Just turn my headphones up.
I feel like you're being difficult.
I'm being difficult?
I feel like it.
I feel like I'm breaking out in hives right now, just irritated with you already.
8 days away from the return of Atlanta Braves baseball on Thunder Radio. We are 68 days away from Memorial Day and the unofficial start of summer. Clint over on Facebook says, is this a real fight? I like it.
Yes.
Yeah, gotta love it.
I wouldn't call it a fight.
It's a spat. It's a spat.
Yeah, 100% real.
Daily, though. Daily. Also another event coming up that I just got wind of yesterday. This is on April the 6th. So I don't have this on the calendar yet, and I'm going to have a story up on it later today. But Coffee County Lady Raider basketball coach Joe Pat Cope has announced they're going to be hosting Sing for the Bling So the world famous The Stash Band.
I like it.
Will be at Prater's April the 6th from 7 until 10. So this is dinner and a concert. And the proceeds of this are going to fund the final four rings for the Lady Raider basketball team. So they want to get the girls' final four rings. I've seen them. They look pretty sweet, pretty nice looking rings. So it's only $40 to go.
You get a show and dinner.
Show and dinner included in that. And
a concert.
That's going to fund the Lady Raider basketball team's rings.
Whoops.
So if you want to help out any basketball player, you can contact them. Joe Pat Cope, you can email him at CopeJ, that's C-O-P-E-J, at K12coffee.net. And email him. He can get you tickets, $40, or you can just show up and pay at the door. $40 at the door, and you get dinner, a show, and you get to help support the Lady Raiders with their really cool, sweet-looking Final Four rings. So I should get him to send me a picture of what they look like. I don't know. Anyway, that's about all I've got today.
For everyone that says there's nothing to do, nothing to do here.
There's always something to do. Just
this is
looking.
Something to do.
Yes. So we have other things, sports from last night. High school softball wins 13-0 over Spring Hill. So that was a pretty simple road trip for them. High school baseball loses 2-0 at Blackman. Got one hit up there. Blackman's a pretty good ball team. Tough luck loss for Timothy Henderson. He didn't get any run support. The only hit of the day from Cole Pippinger, I believe. The middle school Lady Raiders softball team loses to Blackman 12-6. High school soccer ties Lincoln County 1-1. Interesting thing, they're four matches in. That's the first goal they've allowed all year. But they're 2-0-2. They got two ties in there, a 0-0 tie and then a 1-1 tie last night. They weren't able to push ahead. So they in district play, they are 0-0-2. Got some ties in there. And I probably forgot something, but high school baseball tonight at home at 6. High school tennis today on the road at 3. About it, light schedule today. Yesterday, pretty much everybody was on the road. So just a quick rundown of your sports.
The Coffee County and Manchester Animal Control is having an adoption day on March 23rd. That's going to be
this weekend, right?
Mm-hmm, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Golly, I can't even talk right this morning.
Just turn your headphones up a little louder so you can hear yourself.
156 Freedom Drive. Mm-hmm. Go adopt a puppy or an older dog.
Be a foster parent.
For me, I feel like the thought of an older dog is more appealing.
Yeah, they'll die faster.
Well, you don't have to deal with the potty training. And,
hopefully.
Maybe.
For me, the idea of not having a dog at all is pleasant.
We're supposed to be promoting...
Y'all should go get one. Y'all should.
Well, no, y'all need to get it. I won't have another dog.
Y'all need to get an extra one because we're not getting any more.
Pick up our slack.
Pick up our slack. I'm not getting another one. That's about it on the comings and goings. I want to talk productivity today. I don't know if that's in your schedule.
It is. That's what I wrote in my schedule.
That's
an organization because we organize the show.
I don't.
Yeah, we do. We sit down and have meetings and we talk about it. So I knew exactly what you were talking about.
Exactly. What did I hijack from you? Did I take something away?
I didn't have squat here.
Are you for the second segment?
Yeah,
that's what I
was
going to
be. Hello, my baby.
Well, just kill time with something random we come up with.
So I'm glad you got something.
We would just argue about the headphones for a whole segment.
I just don't know. I just don't understand if I'm saying I would like you to turn my headphones up.
Why? I would like you to listen more intently, I guess. I don't know. I
you don't get what you
use
want.
Use more of your energy.
You don't get to, like, control me like a marionette doll.
I do, though.
No.
That's what I want.
No.
In life, is to be able to control everything like that.
I'm getting hard of hearing.
I am. Yeah, I can't see as good. I can't hear as good as I used to.
Maybe you need to put your listening ears on because I was talking normal.
Thunder Radio Morning Show here until 8:30. We're going to talk productivity and organization next. I want your tips here. And it's probably a lot of that going to come from our video group crowd who can comment, but you can call in to the show at 728-1320. We're going to figure out how I can be more productive.
Okay.
It's probably going to require me to stop looking at reels all day.
Yeah.
I'm afraid that that's the answer. 68 for your high today, maybe around 70. Some area frost early, but really not much out there in terms of that. Going to be down around upper 30s, low 40s tonight. Tomorrow, another nice day, 67 degrees. Kind of light winds today, light winds tomorrow. So enjoy that. Sunny, light winds, near 70. Can't beat it. Well, Friday, the rain rolls in. 62, 70% chance of rain. A lot of that later in the day. 70% chance of rain overnight Friday, upper 40s. Saturday, not near as warm. We're going to be in the upper 50s and kind of cool with a 40% chance of rain. We recover nicely on Sunday, though. Upper 60s and sunny skies. So pretty good start to spring break. Weather forecast brought to you by Patton Pest Control. Spring means bugs. Straight up, that's what it means. It means the mosquitoes will be out soon. The wasps will be building nests everywhere. You're going to have ants just marching right on in. Get them out of there with Patton Pest Control. There's no contract obligations. 931-247-0781. You're listening to The Morning Show on Thunder Radio, brought to you by Dr. James Van Winkle.
Enjoy The Morning Show with Josh and Holly on the Carmine Family Dental Camera Perfect Smile Cams. Just find Thunder Radio on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube to watch the show.
Can you hear me okay? What's that there?
Hair.
Come back. We're going to talk.
Oh, we're going to have a good show.
We're going to have a great show.
No.
It's going to be a fantastic show.
No, stone went to the pot.
Don't let the star get in your way.
It's you. You're in my way.
I've done nothing. Absolutely nothing.
I just feel like if Eminem was like, hey, I don't have any snare in my headphones, and the guy that's in control of that was like, no, man, you're good. There's plenty there. What? You turn up the headphones. You put more snare.
I guess I just didn't understand because I was at a certain level before I turned them down to be a smartass. And they were at that level.
See, this is the thing you do, like, with your percentage. You're like, hey, I'm.
I know
where
it was.
There's a 37.
And I know what it was.
37% increase in the amount of birds that come in this, sit on in these bushes. He just makes stuff up.
I'm not making this up, though. I can see where it was. I know where it was.
You didn't make a conscious.
No, I knew where
you were trying to. No, you're being. What did you call yourself?
I'm controlling.
No, you were a... Turning. That's what you get for turning it down.
Shouldn't have turned it down.
Oh, punk.
Well, now Holly's are cranked up over there. I can hear them from over here. Her headphones.
They're where you were at. They're where they were at the beginning of the show.
Not because I adjusted this. Which
you turned them both down. You
I
turned
didn't turn
them,
this down.
I know. You turned it down over there and then didn't turn it back to the level that they were on before.
Good morning, y'all.
I'm sorry for anybody that thinks that this kind of stuff don't happen when you work with your spouse. You must be very happy in your marriage. What did you do yesterday that where you had an epiphany that you needed to be more organized?
I've known this for a while.
Yeah, I know. But what, I mean, why do you want to discuss it?
I don't know. I just feel like there's a discussion needed to be had. Because I guess what's happened is I find a few different productivity hacks that are different in theory. And then I mesh them all together and it's turned into a cluster. It's like if you try the ingredients from a chocolate cake and the ingredients from a cheesecake and the ingredients from cookies. And then you're like, oh, I want this, this, this. And then you can't decide. Then you make that all in one. And then that's what comes out. And it's just a mess. That's what's happened with my ability to be productive.
I have a tip. Just stay off Facebook.
That's not it.
How many videos did you send me last night in a 15-minute?
I was off. I was sitting on the couch. We were watching Mean Girls. By the way, review on that. Too much music.
We're never off.
Well, I was off. I logged out.
Hey, it's Heather with New Haven Mortgage, and you're listening to the Thunder Radio Morning Show with Josh and Holly.
Welcome back, Wednesday edition, Thunder Radio Morning Show. Brought to you by Dr. James Van Winkle. M-Sculpt Neo treatments can get you the look you need for spring and summer. You can tighten up the abs. You can actually spot reduce fat as much as 30% in the area that you're treating. Learn more at drvanwinkle.com. Go by and see a staff. 1030 MacArthur Street in Manchester. Middle Tennessee Surgical Associates. But don't be confused. It's not surgery. And a matter of fact, any of his non-surgery cosmetic work, you get half off if you mention Thunder Radio when you go on in. All right, Holly, welcome back.
Thank you.
We're talking some during the break, and you can always hang out with us during the breaks on the Carmine Family Dental Camera Perfect Smile Cams on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. So I wanted to have a brief discussion, and I want everybody's input on productivity. I'm not productive. I'm not productive at all. So, and if you're listening on the radio, you're welcome to call in with your tips, 728-1320, but I figured we'd get more interaction over on the cameras with this one. So the problem, and I was explaining it some during the break, that I've run into is I've mixed, you know, for over the years, I've ran across a bunch of productivity hacks, how to be more, you know, how to be more productive, how to manage your time, blah, because you get busy. And I've read them all, and I guess what's happened in my brain is I've seen three or four different things that I'd like, and I've meshed them together, but they don't mesh together. Like, it's like one of these things is a cake and the other one is a pie, and I've mixed all that together trying to make something, and it's turned into a mess. And I can give better explanation to it. So I've tried different things. So time blocking is something I tried. And I like the idea of time blocking. I want that to be the thing that works for me. The problem is I don't have the discipline to actually do the stuff during the time block. I'm like, oh, it's now my block of time to do this work. I'm going to look at videos. So I think that's probably what's happened. So, you know, we're time. You set aside time, 2 hours to do sales, 1 hour to do scheduling or whatever. But I've started just ignoring my phone alarms. Like, something goes off and I'm like, oh, it's just time blocking. And so I'm not doing the things I'm supposed to do. And then I came across something later that was like, stop putting off stuff. As soon as it comes across your desk, do it. Like, if you see an email, don't put it off. Do it right now.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, but that's scheduling. Scheduling is not till later today. So then I would get into that mode where I'm like, all right, well, no, as soon as it comes across my desk, I'm going to do it right now. So I don't put it off.
That doesn't mesh well with time blocking.
But it doesn't mesh well with time blocking. So I've started doing kind of both. And then probably overwhelm myself, and then so I sit and watch videos and don't do any of it. So that's the problem that I've run into. So if anybody is more, or I'm just not organized / productive by nature, I have to be motivated. And I don't know if there's a magic system or if I just have to do better. Probably both.
See, I don't feel like I have a hard time doing my work. I feel like when I know it's there, I'll have to do it or it'll irritate me. I may put it off a little, you know, put it to the side, but I feel like I just want to clear my head of it.
And so what you're saying is don't procrastinate.
I'm not a time blocker. I'm more of a, when I see it, get it done.
So you're on that theory. Once it comes across the desk, it needs to be done right now.
The thing I have the most issues with is, putting things into my calendar. Like ribbon cuttings or meetings, mm-hmm. or whatever it is. I didn't have anything to do. You know, I didn't have anywhere to be. I lived the good life, y'all. Yes. I didn't have to go nowhere. I just went to work and come home. And then we
clocked
bought
out and stuff.
And then we bought a radio station.
And you never clock out now.
But somebody will be like, hey, I have a signing on this day. And I'll be like, okay, good. I'll remember it. Why do I think that I'll remember anything?
I know. Holly won't remember anything. And
I don't put the numbers You got a phone call?
Yeah, but I was going to let you finish your
call. I don't put people's names in numbers, with their numbers. No. I'm just not, I don't know.
Morning show.
Hey, Josh. So you're talking about like it was trying to do at the hospital, micromanagement. Won't know exactly how long it took to fix this hole, to paint this wall, and put a floor down. And you can't do it.
What? Yeah.
I may have communicated this wrong.
How do they expect you to keep up with that?
Do what?
They want you to keep up with that?
Yes, that's what Martha would come in there and say. How long will it take to do this room? I said, well, tell me how the humidity is outside for this mud on the sheetrock to dry or the paint to dry. And you can't do nothing like that and give them an exact time frame.
Right.
I may have communicated this wrong. I don't know how long something's going to take. I'm just, you know.
I think he understands what you're saying. Yeah. I think he's just adding to it.
Oh, adding to it. Okay. He's adding to that. I got you. Well, I need to fix my problem, not his problem. It's hard. It's impossible to know how long things like that take.
Yeah.
I get you. Dana says, are you actually focusing on the task or are you just procrastinating? Are you actually not focusing or just procrastinating? Look, I've had more than one person tell me I probably got a little ADD in me. More than one doctor, actually, even though it's not official. I've had a couple been like, because I went to the doctor a long time ago and I was like, I think I'm depressed, man. It was a long time ago. I was like, I got married. I think that's what it is. I just got married and I think I'm depressed now. So is that not what happens? Give me something. And they put me through these tests and they were like, I don't think so. I think maybe ADD is your issue. And they gave me some medicine and I tried it. It worked good.
He took it for 1 month. One month and then never went back for a refill.
To be focused. So
he's not organized enough to even get his medication when he needs it.
When I need it. So I think it's gotten worse with the more responsibility thrown on my plate. It's just like there's so much to do. And I'm like, I'm pretty good at being able to weed out the important things versus the non-important. But I will really the important is a very small pile and I'll weed out pretty much everything else. So
Let me tell you a little bit about Josh. Sunday, he come up to work. There were a couple of problems up here at the station that he needed to fix. He also was supposed to be doing tax stuff. He also wanted to work out, and we also had a game to call. And thrown kind of in the middle there, we wanted to go to Common John.
So what did I do?
So I called and said, hey, I'm going to go to Common John and grab breakfast with our friends hang out with our friends. And he loses his mind. I can't do nothing. I don't have enough time to do this. And he just threw a little temper tantrum.
Well, it's because I had stuff that was on my plate that I didn't do. And I was like, well, I'll do it on Sunday. And then Sunday rolled around and I got busy.
So he's procrastinating.
Laura says, delegate. Who am I going to give it to? Holly, you want to step up your game around here.
What do you want me to do, man? I'll
just do it myself.
He can't let go of something. Let me tell you something. Last night, we were watching a movie with the girl one. And she's 17 years old. She'll be 18. Well, in like 6-7 months, almost an adult. We're watching a PG-13 movie with her. And he is trying to explain the lessons in the movie. Like, say, for instance, we were watching The Lion King. We weren't. But something would happen, and Josh would be like, you see now, girl, when Simba trusted Scar and he shouldn't have. He should have listened to his parents. Always listen to your parents. And I'm like, why are you doing this? This isn't hard to follow. We get it.
Well, she needs
he has a hard time just letting people live their lives and understand the things on their own. He can't, he thinks we're not capable.
And to be fair to me though, the girl one has struggled at times to understand basic things.
Like round money?
Yeah, yeah. She's like, "What would you do? You want? You talking about paper money? You talking about circle money?" Dana says, "In all seriousness, I started taking nootropics and I focus much better." Is that over the counter? Do I got to get a doctor to give me that? And Dr. Carmine says, "We have to make sure they get the point." Yes, that is true. Jessica says, "Ron works from home when he's not out of the country, and when he's here, he says he has trouble focusing on one thing. He will start off 4 work projects, not finish any of them." And that's kind of what happens. I get going with so many things, and I just don't, my brain will start the time blocking, and then it's like, oh, but I got emails. And then I try to stay out of the email. I've tried to do better, but then I made the mistake. I said, well, I'm not even going to check my email. I didn't check my email for 4 days. There was like 500 emails in there. And I was like, oh, now I'm over the, now I'm over.
I don't have near the emails that you get.
It's just so much.
But I have to look at them several times a day. Even on the weekends, I check my email constantly.
I would glance at it on my phone. If I saw something important, I would deal with it. But some things were slipping through. So like I didn't open my Outlook and just go through my inbox. So that's the battle right now is trying to figure out how to be more productive. And pick one, I guess, what method do people use? You know, is it the time blocking? Is it the just handle it as it comes across your desk? You know, just lists. I've seen the priority list. You make a list. You got priority A, B, and C, and you handle all the A's first. Then you get to the B's that you can, the C's. I've seen different ones, and I mix them up and I can't stay focused on one of them.
Normally, if there's something that I don't want to do,
I'll put that off.
I'll put it off until I'm in the mood to do it. And like, there'll be a day that I come in that I'm super productive and I'm like, okay, this needs to be the first.
She means reconciling the bank account. That's the thing that she does that is the most mentally consuming. And she's supposed to do it every month.
I do it every month.
And then one time she's like, can you print me off the last 3 months receipt statements? Cause I hadn't done the reconciling in a minute.
Well,
it was a bad day. That was a bad day.
Because if the money doesn't line up 3 months ago, then you can't move forward. I can't figure out where $37 is.
Dr. Carmine says, hire someone to do the $15 job so you can do the $100 job. Was told that once. While that's a great point, here at the radio station, everything's $15 jobs. Our ads ain't expensive. So I don't know. And I've thought about that. I'm like, well, you know, can I hire more people and take some of the stuff off of me? But then
this is what we do. We'll say we need help. We need to hire somebody. We need to get somebody in here that's going to do that.
We don't trust anybody.
That, and also I'll look at it and I'll go, no, I can do this.
That's what happens.
I can do this.
And then
I'm not hiring somebody to do something I can do on my own. And so here we are.
Dr. Carmine says, Josh definitely needs a personal secretary. Yeah, probably. But Holly's like, I could be your secretary. Do you want me to?
You never gave me the go-ahead that you would do. So, let me tell you something. A secretary tells her boss what he needs to be doing.
I'm not going to listen to that.
I'm his wife. If I say, hey, you need to be doing this, he's going to get like irritated at me.
Yeah, we need more of like a station manager, like a person who handles several different things, like a utility.
I'm gonna
like
do
a Swiss
it today.
Army.
Today.
Well, you're hiring somebody.
No, myself. I'm gonna show you that I can do a good job at it.
Okay.
Today, after we get off the radio, I start my new position as office manager secretary.
I can't wait to see. Can't wait to see how you do that. I'm not going to have time to teach you how to do all the stuff.
No, you're not going to teach me. I'm just going to remind you that you have to do it. I'm going to make sure you're not.
She's going to stay on top of me. I was just thinking about somebody who could do the stuff.
I can do some of it. You can teach me how to do community calendar and obits. Again, I used to know.
Clint says, well, there goes the radio station.
It's going to get better.
Maybe. All right. I got a text from somebody that says time blocking works for me when I write it down. Tuesdays and Thursdays have this. My time is blocked. Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Yeah, I get that. And I've got my time blocked. Look, I put it in the schedule. It's in my calendar. You know, sales 10 to 11, scheduling 2 to 3, all this other stuff. Do ad reviews Friday at noon. But when's the last time I actually did an ad review? You want to know when? Never. I just put it in there because it's something I need to do. I probably just am not disciplined enough is what it is.
You have that. Can I have access to that?
Yeah, you're going to just need to get a little bit more of a detailed knowledge of who's actually advertising with the station and what they're doing.
I do have an idea of that because I do the accounting, so I see all that.
Glenn with all the answers. Just chop all the drama and stress and everything will work out. I'm with you.
You want him to divorce me?
Get rid of Holly and everything will work out great. Well, this has been productive therapy, everybody. I've gotten nowhere. And my plan to hire a young female secretary has not worked out.
Yeah, you got one. Hello, I'm right here. I'm starting my new position today.
Office manager.
I think you're going to be impressed.
Can't wait to see how you do at it.
We'll have an update for you tomorrow.
We've got to do a better. See, then what happens is about 8, I'm like, man, I'm hungry. Let's get some breakfast. And then
we'll end up down at Common John.
That's where we're going to go. And I can't do all the radio things down there. I think what it boils down to is discipline and actually doing what we're supposed to do. But I feel like, well, we handle the broadcast well and the morning show marginally. So what else could we be expected to do with our time?
Yeah.
Thunder Radio Morning Show brought to you by Dr. Van Winkle. We've solved some problems today. I've got some medicine to try. So we'll give that a nootropics.
Don't get irritated with me later when I'm managing you.
That's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. All right. Thunder Radio Morning Show brought to you by Dr. Van Winkle. We're across the top of the hour. We'll let you know what's happening over Prater's when we come back. It's Wednesday, I believe. So that's Meatloaf Wednesdays. We're going to have Name That Tune, Chance to Win Prizes, all coming up in a minute. Morning show here until 8:30, brought to you by Dr. Van Winkle.
Think you have to settle for mediocre car insurance to save money? Think again. It's possible to...
I say it's all settled now. Time blocking, I think, is where it's at. What happens is I get busy, or I forget to put something in my time block or whatever. There's a mixture of big picture things and day to day things that I just have a hard time separating, I guess, is the problem. I just need to do better. There's really no excuses. I just need to do better.
I was really productive yesterday.
Yeah, productive day.
Mm-hmm. In different aspects.
Yeah.
Like when we're here, we have to do more. There's the morning show stuff, and then there's the sports stuff.
Yeah.
And then there's like financial things that we have to take care of, or I have to take care of. And then there's Dream for Weave stuff and foundation things and Thundy stuff.
Yeah. And then separate that out too for now.
And then also we have kids.
Yeah. And then separate that out of the house. There's a pool project and a building project going on there. So, and I mean, just listen to our first world problems.
I'm thankful.
I have
for
to build
all
a pool. I mean, I don't mean it that way. I just mean it like then it gets overwhelming in my head, and then I start to freak because I'm like, I'm gonna screw something up, I'm gonna forget something, I'm gonna forget to pay something or whatever, and so then I get stressed before anything's even happened.
It's all figure outable, I think.
Probably. And then what I'll do is, I'll spend a ton of energy trying to get it all fixed. Like, I'll spend all this energy trying to get it all lined up. And then I'm exhausted mentally. And then I don't want to do anything for a week. And then I feel like such a slacker because I'll get an email from, like, Sean Trail at 1 in the morning. He's like, I just left the office. Just saw your email. I'm like, oh.
Well.
I went to sleep at 7:30 last night, so.
I got a message from Wisteria Hill.
Yeah.
And she was like, hey, you guys haven't billed me. That's pitiful.
Bill the advertisers. It's on my list. Solid.
That's bad when they're coming to you and like, I want to pay you.
I had a note yesterday that I don't think I put them in the billing list. And then I still didn't do it. And then I'm glad you reminded me. So, yeah, I mean, we just have to be better. We need the morning show to blow up, like, big. And then we can hire support staff. Amber said, just think, we were kids, we wanted to be adults. That's right. I didn't. No, I probably
didn't. I wanted to be grown up so bad.
Jessica said, well, there's the problem. You're working for free. That is the problem. And also, we will give away our services too often. Holly will. Had a lot of people tune in this morning. We had our viewers up over 60, and they listened to that productivity talk, and they got the hell out of here. Meatloaf day?
It is.
I'm going to get a before and after of your smile to put on the screen. It's commercial screen. We don't have good systems in place, I feel like. It's just kind of willy-nilly.
Teeth. You know,
we don't have good systems.
We'll just search teeth and see.
Like a... But then I got that software that one time. I hated it.
On Thunder Radio.
Thunder Radio Morning Show brought to you by Dr. Van Winkle. Talk to him about Tempsure Envy treatments. These are simple in-office treatments. You're going to stimulate collagen growth, and it's almost kind of like Botox without the needles or the injections. Learn more at drvanwinkle.com. We've been solving our productivity problems this morning, sort of. And more discussion during the break. You can always hang out with us on the cameras, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Holly, welcome back.
Thank you.
Okay. So, Prater's, what is for lunch today?
All right, they've got the meatloaf today. Pork loin over dressing. Smoked pulled pork.
You want me to do some of that?
Mashed potatoes with brown gravy, pinto beans, green peas, squash, potato salad, coleslaw, and side salad. Listen, y'all, on the break, he said, is it meatloaf today? And I said, yeah. And so I thought he was pulling that up. Find Prater's at 620 Woodbury Highway.
I would if I could find it. See, that's the problem.
Hey, Ma! Can we get some meatloaf? The meatloaf! We want it now! The meatloaf!
All right. Holly, name that tune.
All right. Josh has got a little snippet of a song. He's going to play a little clip, a 1, 2, and a 3-second clip. Once you have figured out the name of the song, give us a call on the Ben Lohman hotline. The area code is 931-728-1320, or you can dial 728-3526 for a chance to win.
Swag.
Yeah, if you get it on the 1-second clip, you can get some Black Rifle coffee and a t-shirt. 2 and 3-second clips, just a t-shirt. Right. You have to know the name of the song and the artist.
Right, let's do it. 728-1320.
Name that tune and artist.
They're going to get it. And if it takes
I feel like I picked a good spot.
Listen close. Oh, somebody's already on it. Morning show.
Is it Charlie Daniels of South going to do it again?
Nope. Oh, good guess.
Try, but not it. No. Holly stumped him. If you get the wrong answer, you are welcome to call back and try again. 728-1320. What are you doing over there?
I'm looking for before and after teeth pics.
See, that's the thing. Productivity.
I'm just doing what you said.
I know, but it's like, do we do it right now, this very moment? We got a show.
That's what I'm saying. If something comes across
and I'm more of like, put it down, but then I don't do it.
And then you forget. Yeah, but at least I'm getting it
done. But then you're
not
engaged in the show. Jessica Addison said this sublime. Morning show.
Charlie Daniels sitting on a bar stool, acting like a darn fool.
No, good guess, not right.
Oh, man. Holly's got him stumped. Boom, boom, boom. Stumped today.
Shooter.
All right, let's go to the 2-second clip. Get you a little more. And if it takes
all night, I'm going. Last caller had the correct song. They were singing the lyrics, but that's not the exact right
name. Not the name of the song.
And I'm going to be honest with you. That's not the exact right name of the artist.
So, I always get a little nervous when people start calling in with names that are wrong, because Holly sometimes will be confused in her head and will have the wrong answer. Let's see. Morning show.
I have a birthday for you.
All right.
What do you got?
Go ahead.
Topsy, T-O-P-S-Y, Lane, L-A-Y-N-E.
All right. Got it down.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Let's try a 2-second clip here. We're moving on. It was a shirt and coffee. Now we're going for a t-shirt. Coffee's off the table. And if it takes all night, I'm going. See, this is also another thing. Holly.
Oh, my gosh.
No, we've had this discussion. I said, we need a before and after of your smile to push the Dr. Carmine, you know, smiles. And I need that in an email. She'll text it every time. So then I've got to email
it
to
myself. That's how I do business.
I know, through text. We do business through email. I can't just put it on the screen.
I tell her that
every time.
Then say email me. Don't say send me.
Morning show.
Drinking My Baby Goodbye by Charlie Daniels.
Holly?
So try the artist again. There's more than one. Like, it's a group. It's...
I don't even know. So, Drinking My Baby Goodbye.
Charlie Daniels Band?
Yes, there you go.
There you go. Charlie Daniels Band. Drinking My Baby Goodbye. Charlie Daniels Band. Who are we talking to?
Brandon.
Good job, Brandon. All right. Come on by. I got you a Thunder Radio shirt. You've got it today.
All righty. Thank you.
Yes.
So, listen.
Wait, I'm going to drink my baby goodbye. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Good job, Holly. Good job today.
So I know every word.
Hang on. Somebody's calling. This is probably Rachel Williams. Morning show.
Did somebody pick the winner yet?
Yeah, we just got it. What were you going to say? Right. What were you going to say?
Drinking My Baby Goodbye, Charlie Daniels Band.
Boom,
oh,
you had it. You had it. What's your name?
It's Dr. Carmine. I was getting my kid ready. And oh. I said, I know that song.
I mean, just missed it. We'll hook you up with a shirt anyway.
You got it exactly right.
All right. Have a good one.
All right, buddy.
Rachel Williams said, won't be me this time. No. About 5 minutes later is when she calls in.
So when I was like 10 or 11, when we first, you know, I may have been 12. We would take trips to go visit my meemaw down in Georgia. And I don't know if this is the only cassette tape we owned. I don't think it was on a CD. I think it was a cassette. But my parents would put that tape in, the Charlie Daniels Band, whatever that album was, and we would listen to it just about the whole way there. And every time that we did this around Chattanooga area, you'd have to flip it over. So I would know.
Yeah, you knew where you were.
Oh, I'm like, well, we must be around Chattanooga because we're having to flip the Charlie Daniels Band tape over.
Oh, man. The days of turning the tapes over.
So now I definitely know the words to all those songs. Was it the only tape we owned? I don't know. Maybe.
I feel like the only tape we owned for a long time was TLC.
Don't Go Chasing Waterfalls.
Waterfalls, man. Yeah, heard a lot of that. Amanda said 8-track tape. No, no.
Not an 8-track.
No, no.
Just a regular cassette.
Regular tape. No, just the old cassette tapes.
All right. You got an email incoming.
Oh, I figured out how to do it, so don't worry about it.
You did?
I figured out how to get it to my drive, because I really needed it in my drive. So I figured out how to get it to my drive.
How did you do it? Just saved it and put it there yourself?
Well, yeah.
Oh, my gosh. That's what you were going to have to do with the email anyway.
Yeah.
So I want to... You owe me an apology.
I apologize, Holly, for asking you to work with modern technology.
I'm sorry. Is this iPhone not modern technology? Forgive me.
Ask her if she can work a laptop.
I have a laptop. I use a laptop daily. Why are you want to make me angry? You won't like me when I'm angry.
All right. Congratulations to Brandon. Honorable mention to Dr. Carmine, who was able to get the song and the artist right. Charlie Daniels Band. Drinking My Baby Goodbye. All right. News break here. Stupid, silly stat. Joke of the day when we come back. We got so much more fun on the Thunder Radio Morning Show. Before we take a break, let's get a look at the current temperature outside. Sun is bright. Kind of chilly. 35 degrees, but we're going to heat up nicely. Up around 68 today. Light winds, 5 to 10 out of the south. I got to shift out of the north in the afternoon. Could be a little cooler, but it's going to be a nice day. Temperature update brought to you by Wisteria Hill Boutique. So they have all of your Easter dresses. I know ladies are looking for those Easter dresses. Church, family pictures, Sunday dinner, Easter Sunday dinner, whatever you're looking for. They've got them at Wisteria Hill. Go by and check them out. 205 South Woodland Street. Near downtown Manchester, Wisteria Hill, Wisteria. Tell them Thunder Radio sent you.
Now, another update from the WMSR Thunder Radio News Center.
This local news update.
So they had this really cute dress at Wisteria Hill, right when you walk in the door on the right.
Yep.
Nope. Yep. I said right, but I pointed left.
See, she does that. She does that when I'm driving. We'll be in a busy area, and she'll be like, okay.
I'm like, you need to take a right.
She's like, you're going to take a left here, and I'll have to get across three lanes of traffic. And then she's like, oh, no, oops, I meant right.
Let me tell you why I do that.
Yeah, this has been happening for years.
Prior to buying the radio station, I worked in radiology. And when you look at an X-ray, it's inverted. So if I'm looking at it, my right
she don't look at the X-ray
left.
In 4 years.
Yeah, but I did it for over 10 years. You develop habits and tendencies. It's the equivalent of picking up a phone when you're at home and saying Thunder Radio. It's just something that's habitual. Anyway. A dress. It's white and it's got the prettiest blue flower print on it. It would be a perfect Easter. I started to get it for the girl one, but I didn't. I probably will, though. I'll probably go back and get it. I think I will.
Let's get this sunlight out here. I got this before and after Holly's teeth. See if I can get this up on the screen.
I think that we would only gain from giving to them, especially
here.
If they're training to get our kids out.
Come on. Screen share. Share screen. Window. There. There. There's Holly's before and after her teeth for the Carmine family dental folk. They did a great job. So y'all can take care of that with Dr. Carmine. I got that before and after up on the screen.
I love my teeth.
Yes. Deckard, Dr. Carmine, Family Dental. Y'all check that out. Morning, Matt. What? Shannon Frank's birthday is tomorrow. Get it down.
What we got coming up right here? Joke of the day and stat.
Joke of the day and stat. Yes.
All righty. Stat coming at you. And also, joke for me.
All these notifications.
Jokey joke. Got it. Boom, I'm on top of it.
Yes, Holly.
Braves played the Blue Jays today? Spring training?
Spring training. I don't know who they're playing.
Blue Jays.
Trina Rice said, I had to turn the radio off when I got to work, but I know what you're talking about. Organization. She said, I think y'all got it, though. No, we don't. We do not. A good song here. Let's play a little George Michael.
All right. I'm going to use this time to post the game day.
I had chili 2 days in a row. I'm very uncomfortable right now. That's all I'm going to say. We had a lot of chili Monday night, and then there was leftover chili, so I had it last night.
Do you feel like leftover chili is better?
Usually.
Was it not?
No, it was.
Oh, you said usually, no. Like this time was an exception.
No. Usually. No. Homemade leftover chili. Just, you know, I guess it depends. We did not have spaghetti, Hattie. She fixed chili like I told her to.
I love spaghetti. Chili. You'll have spaghetti tonight, though.
No, I will not. I'm probably going to go to Wendy's and get me some more chili. We're out.
You will eat it. You will like it.
There's some things that I don't ring the bell for.
Jessica commented on a TikTok that I had posted where I was clamped down on the dentist finger.
Oh, yeah.
And she was like, oh, man. She's like, I would have wore the bell out. And I'm like, well, we kind of try to.
Yeah.
I could
sit here. That's a commercial now, though.
I could sit here and ring this bell all day. Yeah, all just day. Constantly.
That's a commercial now. It's supposed to be a best of segment, but I went to look in there to play it the other day when we were out, and I couldn't find it. So I may have forgot to stick it in, but we'll add it. I'll go back in there and look today. If I'm organized, I've already done that, but I'm not organized.
Hey, today's the day, buddy.
I'm going to get organized today. I also want Common John breakfast.
Holly is the planner, the brains, and the looks. She just needs Josh to push all the fancy buttons.
The snowflake button makes it cold, cold, cold. Set temperature makes it hold, hold, hold.
This is the morning show with Josh and Holly.
Thanks for hanging out with us. It's been a good show today. We got an hour in, we got an hour left, officially at the midway point of your Wednesday hump day edition of the Thunder Radio Morning Show. Josh and Holly with you, getting you to work, getting you to school, getting you home from work. Good time to remind everybody how you can catch the show. AM 1320, that's the OG right there, the original. 1320 on the AM, we've been there since 1957, or WMSR as. You can also listen at 107.9 FM, 106.7 FM. You can listen worldwide on the Manchester Go app and at thunder1320.com. You can watch the show over on the Carmine Family Dental Camera Perfect Smile Cams. We during the break, and I'll put it up again right now, we have Holly's before and afters of her teeth up there. And of what Dr. Carmine did over at Carmine Family Dental. So you can have that done as well. We'll post it to Facebook again later so you can see. But for you radio people, I can hold it up to the microphone, but I can't do much good. Shannon said, look like Holly stopped dipping that tobacco.
I know. I still dip it. She does not.
Back in the high school days when you actually swallowed the tobacco.
Yeah, that was pretty disgusting. I don't think I've ever been that sick.
Even since?
No, I definitely have.
Okay. I'm fixing to say there's a certain Sunday I recall. I'm not going to say anything else about it. She got sick on a Sunday.
self-induced. And she didn't come back to the morning show till Wednesday. We didn't see her.
Why are we doing
till
this?
Wednesday. All right. So we got things we need to do here. Joke of the day.
What did the llama say to his date?
What did the llama say to his date?
Uh-huh.
What's that now?
Want to go on a picnic? Alpaca lunch. Joke of the day is brought to you by Board and Brush in Manchester. If you don't get that one, have your parents explain it to you. Alpaca lunch. It's cute. Board and Brush is perfect for just about any occasion, like birthday parties for kids and adults, bachelorette parties, work groups, sports teams. You don't have to be super crafty to enjoy this. The ladies at Board and Brush are going to help you the entire time. Learn more at boardandbrush.com.
I can do it.
/Manchester. Follow them on Facebook and look out for their specialty workshops.
boardandbrush.com/Manchester.
And now it's time for stupid, silly statistics that you never knew.
I don't know where you're getting your statistics.
And probably don't need.
Him, did you bring your statistics?
Stupid silly stat revved up by our friends over at Freedom Automotive. A lot of people taking spring break trips, whether you're, maybe you're taking a long trip, you know, down to Florida, or maybe it's just a day trip. You're headed to Gatlinburg or just to do some hiking over spring break next week. Make sure your vehicle is ready to go and get all your basic maintenance, your alignments. You want to make sure that's done well. Wheels and tires, you need a good set of tires on that vehicle before you hit the road. Freedom Automotive, they do all of that, plus exhaust, catalytic converters, all of it at Freedom Automotive. Get on by and see them at 515 Hillsboro Boulevard in Manchester. That's 515 Hillsboro Boulevard in Manchester, right in front of College Street Elementary, open 6 days a week. Holly?
A study found that couples who share similar tastes in this are happier than couples who don't. A study found that couples who share similar interest in this or similar taste in this are happier than couples that don't.
728-1320 or 728-3526 to take your guesses at it today.
Where'd you go?
I was looking at some guesses. Jessica says music.
It's a good guess.
It is. Holly and I do not share similar taste in much of anything. Morning show.
Music.
Music. Good guess, but not it. Good try. And I'm not saying that's wrong, but it's just, it's wrong today. Morning show.
Television shows.
TV shows. Good try, but not it.
Gotta watch my stories.
Gotta watch my stories. Shannon Frame says, nowadays, I'm going to say men. That's not right.
A study found that couples who share similar tastes in this are happier than couples that don't.
Morning show.
Sports teams.
Sports teams. Good guess. You ever see those house divided license plates and stuff? I don't see how those people live. That's not it.
Could you date someone that was an Alabama fan?
Not unless they converted.
Okay.
Maybe now. There's the deal about it. So now, yeah, I could, because I don't take it as serious. But like getting married at age 25 or 26 or however old we were, 24. And at that time, no, because I would have hit her. I'm like, I didn't mean to, officer, but she started talking trash after the ball game. Like, I don't like when people talk trash after a game if my team loses. I won't talk trash about your team. Morning show.
Restaurants.
Good try, but not it. She never picks. Morning show.
Is it similar taste in food?
Food. Good try, but no, not it. Good try.
I think sometimes it works to our advantage that we don't like similar foods because I always get his pickle.
That is true, because I'm not going to eat that. House divided tags are a sign that the wife wears the pants in the family. The comment coming from over on the video feed.
Oh, that's funny.
Morning show.
Automobiles.
Automobiles. Good try, but no, not in. Holly, read the question for us.
A study found that couples who share similar taste in this are happier than couples who don't.
It's a more basic answer than you think. Don't get too complex here. It's a more basic answer than you think. We've had these guesses. Music, TV shows, restaurants, food, automobiles, sports teams. None of that's right.
Laura guessed the outdoors.
Dr. Carmine says wine. True that.
We share similar.
We don't drink dry wine. I can't do dry wine. Morning show.
Is it the temperature in the house?
That's a good guess.
That's a great guess, and that should be probably the right answer, but it ain't. Morning show.
Friends.
Good guess, because that's kind of basic, but not it. You know, I can't imagine my friends not being your friend. Like, we just hang out with the same people.
Yeah.
Like, I don't have friends.
They're our friends.
Yeah. Holly's got a few friends that aren't really my friends, but that's fine.
A study found that couples who share similar tastes in this are happier than couples who don't.
Amanda says sleep. Agreed. Morning show.
Vacation destination.
Vacation destination is a good guess, but not it.
I'm just saying the world's bigger than Panama City Beach. That's
she
all
says
I'm
that.
Saying.
She says that, but then she's like, I want to go book our trip down Panama City Beach for the fall.
You know why? Because it's relatively close.
Yeah, she don't like to ride in the car. Had an offer for a plane ride. She's like, nah, I don't want to do that either.
I tried to imagine myself in a smaller plane. I've ridden on a commercial
one.
Airline.
Yeah, how
a
would you do
times.
On a smaller?
How,
like
how would I? Just please, just knock me out first. That feels like
I haven't ridden in a small plane since I was little. Like, and we just kind of did an up and around here kind of flight.
A study found that couples who share similar tastes in this are happier than couples who don't. I'm going to give a little hint here. This is something that is very important to me.
This is tops on. This is maybe one of the very few things that we do have in common. Holly yeah. and I, on a scale of 1 to 10, are about a 2 on the compatibility scale in terms of things we have in common. But this is one of the things. This brings us up from a 0.
And I want to say it's important to me.
Morning show.
Rest time.
Good try, but not it. I think you said rest time.
Yeah. This is something that
you want your you
I'm
want
not
your
gonna, I'm not gonna it. I'm not gonna bend on this.
Dana says child rearing.
That's important too, because there's sometimes you don't always see eye to eye on discipline.
Not always, but we mostly see eye to eye there. I'm a little harsher than Holly.
No.
Morning show.
Home decor.
Home decor. Good try, but no, not it. Think real basic. What?
Oh, nothing. I'm joining a new club this week.
Oh. No.
Laura said pets.
Pets. Morning show.
Mm-hmm.
You say cleaning?
Yes.
Not it, though. Good try. Morning show. I think I accidentally hung up on them. Sorry. I hit the button twice.
Should I give a hint?
I guess. I thought we
Is
were
good. Is it too early?
No, we can go ahead and give one. Christina says political views.
Ooh, that's important.
Yeah, you're going to want to be the same there, probably. Morning show.
Is it careers?
Good try, but no, not it.
Nikki says communication. That's important.
Yeah, that's not a. I don't know. Read this again and give a hint after this guess. Morning show.
Is it music?
No, not it.
A study found that couples who share similar taste in this are happier than couples that don't.
We've had a gazillion guesses. I can't keep up with them.
I just let me try and steer folks back in the right direction. It's something you're going to probably notice on a first date if you have similar.
All right. If this is a similarity,
taste in it.
You'll notice this on a first date, or at least within the first date or two. You may even notice
it. Probably within meeting them.
Yeah. You may could even notice it from their social post. Who knows? Morning show.
Fashion.
Good try. Not it. You would notice that. Morning show.
Is it grooming?
No, it's not grooming. Good
That's
try.
That's important, though.
Similar desire to be well-groomed. Shannon says hygiene. I got hygiene. A bunch of guesses. It's not hygiene. Morning show.
Miles?
Say smiles?
Yes.
Not it. Good try. It's not physical.
Yeah.
It's not physical. You'll notice this on the first date. It's not physical. I feel like we're giving it away. Morning show.
Family time.
Oh, good try. But not it. Good try. Not it. Family time. No more hints. I think we've given it away. It's something you're going to notice on the first date or two. It's not physical. It's not. Somebody said looks. Morning show.
Food or wine.
What was that?
Food or wine.
Not it. Good try. I'll be honest. I didn't know what they said, but it wasn't the right one. Morning show.
Religion.
Good try. It's not religion, though. That fits all the hints, but it's not it. Morning show.
Manners?
Not manners. I can't believe y'all haven't got this.
Amy said when her friend, her kids get a new friend, she asked them, do they love Jesus? Who do they cheer for? And how do they vote?
Morning show.
Have money?
Hey. Have money. Good try, but not it. Not it.
That's what I should have looked out for.
Yeah.
Instead, I went with the answer.
Yeah, Holly went with the answer here. If she went for money, her and I would not be on the morning show right now. But she was more interested in what the answer actually is. This is something you're going to notice. Couples that share this are happier than couples who do not, according to a study. And our hints are it's not physical, and it's something you're going to notice in the first date or two. Not physical. Come on now.
Hey, Kate got it.
Morning show.
Humor.
Boom. Yes, there it is. Humor. Couples that share same sense of humor tend to be far happier than couples who do not. What is your name?
Lindsay.
Lindsay. Good job, Lindsay. Where do you stand on this? Do you feel like this is important or no?
Oh, yes. I love to laugh. And
yes. Got to have that same sense of humor.
So. Yep.
Well, come on by and get you a Thunder Radio shirt, okay?
All right. Thanks.
Winner, winner today. People were starting to get it right over on Facebook or wherever they're watching. That sense of humor, it was coming in. But
I feel like I have a dark sense of humor.
Oh, yeah.
And
our sense of humor is incredibly inappropriate. Y'all don't know nothing about us.
I have the sense of humor. I don't want to say of a teenage boy because that's not accurate. But it's a little accurate.
Yeah. And our sense of humor, again, it's not one that, like, you hear the sense of humor that we share on the show. There's a little bit different sense of humor we share over on the cameras, on the breaks. And then there's the real us that you're never going to know. There are a few select people who have an insight on it, but not many who know, who we're willing to cut loose around, because we would probably end up in cancel culture jail. We cannot share our sense of humor. Most people would probably be fine with it. I just don't want.
But I have been around other folks who pride themselves in having a good sense of humor. I just didn't think the things that they thought were funny were funny.
Yeah.
Like slap comedy. I never thought that was funny.
Like shock comedy stuff? Or is that a different thing? Like shock comics would be like what Bob Saget was.
No,
he would just like blurt out the most obscene stuff and people would laugh.
No,
and
I'm talking like, about funny. Slap comedy like the Three Stooges.
Oh, Three Stooges. I think that stuff's pretty funny. But I also think you have a good sense of humor as well. The Three Stooges comedy I thought was more funny when I was younger. Like, I don't find it. It's funny now. I can't sit and watch
or,
it. Really.
Or pranks.
I don't do pranks.
I don't like pranks.
I mean, I like a little harmless, not like very detailed pranks, like just little harmless jokes, you know.
Well, like that show that used to come on, was it Pranked? Is that the name of it?
I never watched it.
But they would do stuff where they would make a celebrity think that their car was damaged or like something that would upset you.
Yeah, and you might get a reaction out of me that you may not
like.
Don't get me upset. Don't get me upset.
Yeah, that's not funny.
Like, I never was a big fan of you know, even the small things, like stealing somebody's phone or telling them it's broken. Things like that, I'm out on that. I don't.
Don't play with my emotions.
Yeah, you're going to get me riled up. I don't like that. But, you know, like small little pranks are fine. Like, I'm not an April Fool's person.
I got to say, April Fool's and New Year's, not my favorite holidays.
Yeah. We don't really celebrate.
I don't.
I've seen, news organizations should not celebrate.
Like, put out fake stories?
And that's just a bad idea.
No, well,
it's a bad idea because people online.
What's that basketball play?
It's like
football.
It's social media PR 101. People on social media do not understand sarcasm. It doesn't translate. And so only half the people will get it at best. And then you end up with a mess. And I've seen some people go, wait, that should be a segment. Too far, April Fools.
Okay.
I
got time to work on it.
Pranks or jokes pulled by like news organizations where they were like, oh, the mayor died or whatever, you know, like just way too, like, what are you thinking? Like, who approved that?
Yeah.
Like, who, at what point was like, yeah, that's good. Go with it. Yeah. Somebody greenlighted that. Like, where random stuff. I think WMSR 1 year before we bought the station had told everybody they were going to a rap format.
That's funny.
And got people tore up.
No, I think that's
calling
funny.
In. We're never listening. You've ruined our station.
Those people need to calm down.
Yeah. But this was before. I think this was even before they had the FM. Like, it was 1320 The Groove. Like, it was oldies. We're going to rap. And people were like, no more swap and shop. It's all rap. I don't know exactly what that was.
A few years ago, I remember Michael Strahan debuting his teeth. He got fixed. Oh, you know, he's got that big
gap.
Yeah. And it's kind of like a signature look for him. He got it filled in and people were like, no, not your gap. But it was a joke.
So
if you want your gap filled in, go see Dr. Carmi.
I was about to ask if Dr. What he do about that gap? Dr. Carmi, he just commented and was like, you know, people get crazy on TikTok. I get hate messages all the time over sarcasm. And so I finally found his TikTok.
Oh, yeah.
I did not realize he was such a celebrity on TikTok. Like, dude has got, like, thousands and thousands of followers.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Did you
No, I'm going now. I'm going to follow now.
You don't follow him?
I guess.
Mine's starting to play videos. I got to turn that down real quick. There's no telling what I've got pulled up on my phone.
What's he under?
Carmine Dentist is what I Googled, and then it's a smile. It's the smile doctor. Smiles doctor. SMILEZDR. He's got 22,000 followers over there.
Golly.
Yeah. And some of his videos, 12,000 views, 20,000 views. I mean, just lots. 12,000 views, 14,000, 18, 23, like a lot of views over there. This one's got 903,000 views. I'm assuming that may be the one he's talking about oil pulling. I hadn't watched it, but he said that he got viral on one of them. It's nearly a million views. So, yeah. Now go find him over on the... You can't find him?
Mm-mm.
Just type in Carmine Dentist, and I got it to pull up. It's SMILEZDR.
You tell me to look up one thing and then start spelling another. Okay, I found him.
Yeah, he said it's oil pulling. Is the one. He talked about that when he joined us.
He's got almost 22,000 followers. How many do we have?
Like four. It's not even close. We've got to get more. Well, and we just post, you know, sports stuff, which people like, but we got to get more viral.
We got 2,200.
Oh.
He's got 22,000.
We need to start paying him to promote our TikTok channel so we can get more.
He's posting more. I need to post more content.
We got to post more content. Yeah. But again, see, this is back to our organization talk, Holly, that we had earlier in the show. We want, you know, we need, you know, TikTok followers, Instagram followers, Facebook followers. Those are important for us, but not as important as the basic functions of the station. So I get away from that, and I focus on, you know, the broadcast, the schedules, the billing, you know, things that we have to, you know, it's kind of like, I know you got to do those things, but I end up not prioritizing it because I've got to do these other things.
Yeah.
First. See what I'm saying? Shannon Frame says, let me come in, do a live one morning. We'll grow your followers. All right, 10 minutes till top of the hour. We are way past due. We may actually have to do Wednesday's Worst Criminal in the 8 o'clock hour, Ollie. We are that far behind.
Oh, so we are. That's fine.
Yeah, we're behind. Comet Jump Brewing Company is open today for lunch, breakfast, dinner. I went out of order there. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner starting at 8 a.m. Get on by and see them. It's going to be a good day to sit outside, isn't it? It's going to be about 70. Oh, see?
We can have a business meeting over.
I have to wait on to warm up a little.
Okay.
Comet Jump Brewing Company, 210 Woodbury Highway. Try a couple of different things on the menu. For breakfast, I go breakfast burrito all day. Now, for lunch, a couple of different things. Pizza is good. Holly really likes the hot dog. Try that out over at Comet Jump Brewing Company. They got beer all day long. Get coffee in the morning. 210 Woodbury Highway. Family-friendly atmosphere. Singo tonight, Wednesday night, and then tomorrow night, it is karaoke. Comet Jump Brewing Company.
Coffee County Bank is here for all your banking needs. Whether you need a checking account, a money market, or even a CD, our friendly experts are here to help you. Call us today to get our great...
Can you shut these curtains? I need like a draw curtain. The sun gets us in the mornings. I like to have it open. I want to be able to see
outside. Dr. Carmine has a lot of videos where he's like talking to the camera.
No, yeah, his are great. But I don't have I don't have anything fun to say. His are fun. His are on topic for dentistry. But that, you know, what am I supposed to do? Sit here and talk about radio? I don't know what I'm supposed to talk about there.
Who won the birthday yesterday?
Birthday yesterday's winner. Oh, that's today. Trinina Stanley. Now, the oil pulling one has almost 1 million views. People did not like that, I don't think. But these are great. Like, his videos are great. But again, like, you know, his ones of, like, not dental related don't do as well. You know, like, he talks football, you know, it's 2,000 views. Or concrete work, it's 3,000 views. But he gets into smiles and, you know, family ones, 2,000 views. People want, they like the dental ones. So if I'm advising him, it's going to be all dental stuff. That's what I know. Birthdays are next.
Y'all are gonna watch me make a TikTok.
Right now?
Yeah, I'm gonna do it right now. What can I say?
See, that's the thing. You don't have to have some good content.
I don't have anything to talk about. See, that's my problem. I'm not a big talker. I have a Give me a topic, radio related, or no? It doesn't have. It could be community related.
Good morning, Jennifer.
You said that so. Morning, Jennifer.
That's good
better.
Heavy.
That's better.
Sorry, I'm trying to think about a topic for you. Make sure the schedule's on time. And
you want to do it. You want to talk?
I have nothing to say. See, I'm not going to put something out. Just put something out.
All right, I'm doing it. Let's see here. Now, y'all go later and like this TikTok that I'm about to make. Am I on TikTok or am I on Snapchat?
See, this is a problem. What am I even on right now?
Enhance me. Matter of fact, I may need some makeup. Animation creator. Tap screen to capture a frame. Add more frames. Start. Tap the screen.
I'm going to send a snap. Holly making TikToks just mid-show.
Wait a minute. I don't.
Oh, we got Yellowstone.
Tap the screen to add frames.
Yeah, I get that off. Yes. Now I'm ripped.
Wait a minute. What? I don't know how this works.
I'm a cowboy. See, this is how Holly's TikTok life's going.
Okay, record.
We have two birthdays now.
Oh, I accidentally posted that. Shoot.
Take it down.
Look.
Nice. What does it say?
Tap the screen to add friend. How do I remove this? This has gone horribly wrong.
Birthday time. I'll do these while Holly makes a TikTok that she's accidentally posted somehow.
I took it down.
Over there during the break. What is our TikTok channel? What is the handle?
At Thunder Radio.
Simple. At Thunder Radio. Y'all go follow us. We're getting beat by a dentist. We got to do better. Birthday time. Calling the birthdays. 728-1320. We'd love to hear from you. At the end of the day, 4:30. Tiffany will be on Connecting Coffee County. If you haven't caught that show, highly recommend it. 3 to 5 or 3 to 6 with Tiffany. And she's always talking to local folks, attacking local issues. At 4:30, though, she stops and she draws for a winner of a slice of birthday pie from the Mercantile Cafe Bakery. Yesterday, Trinina Stanley was the winner of that slice of pie. You come on by here and get your certificate at the Thunder Radio Studios. And then at the end of the day, or end of the week, we draw for a birthday cake from the Food Lion. Drum roll, please, Holly. Today's birthdays. I got three so far. Happy birthday. Topsy Lane has a birthday today. I'm not trying to be mean, but that sounds like an older name.
Topsy? Yeah.
Yeah, like you hear that and you're like, that lady's 70 with a bowl of deviled eggs going into the church with, you know, for potluck. Y'all gonna go over and get some of Topsy's deviled eggs.
Yeah. That's...
Like, is that not just sound stereotypical?
Yeah, but I thought Topsy was a male.
He? She?
It could be either.
I don't know a lot of Topsies.
I've heard the name before. I thought it was a male. Like umpire? Was there a Topsy that umpired?
I don't remember any Topsies.
Okay.
Google that up. See if that's a male or a female name or unisex. Gary and Carrie. Holly completely misspelled Carrie. It's K-E-R-R-Y, isn't it?
No, Carrie, you.
She put down C-A-R-Y. I'm pretty sure that ain't right.
What? You're throwing me off. I'm supposed to be looking at celebrity birthdays, looking at Topsy.
I'm just looking for the Gannon spelling.
Topsy is Bobby Lane's wife. Okay.
Yeah, Carrie Gannon, K-E-R-R-Y, not C-A-R-Y. So Gary and Carrie Gannon with a birthday. And Brady Wright turning 17 years old today. Happy birthday to all those folks. Morning show.
Topsy, this isn't the lady Topsy. Her husband had something to do with the ball team. I can't remember what it was.
Okay, so it's a female Topsy, you said.
Yes. She worked at the post office for years and everything. So she's a nice lady. Happy birthday, Topsy.
How old is Topsy? Do you know?
No, I don't want to go there.
Don't want to go there. All right. But it sounds like I'm right. I haven't heard a lot of younger Topsy.
I see it.
All right. Kate, thank you for calling.
Kate sent me a picture
of
Miss Topsy, and she's got her candles on her birthday cake.
Okay.
So it's out there.
Does she make good deviled eggs?
It looks like Topsy would be the deviled egg. Okay. You would want to eat her deviled eggs for sure. She can cook. I can just tell by looking at her.
Kevin says TikTok video that you're making should be just the day in the life of a radio host. See, nobody cares.
I'm gonna do it though.
It's gonna be a reality show around here.
I'm gonna make it look like I do a lot more work than I actually do.
Happy birthday to all of our folks: Brady, Gary, Carrie, Topsy, all with birthdays today. We draw this afternoon at 4:30. We can add to that list anytime. 728-1320. We're crossing the top of the hour. We got 30 minutes left. What?
Oh, you didn't even let me do celebs.
Oh, sorry. Yes, celebrities. Go ahead.
Well, I want to take this time to say that Carrie, C-A-R-Y, is a way to spell a man's name.
It is a way to smell it.
And here's a list of Gary's or Carrie's with that name. So I don't have any celebrity birthdays. I just wanted to say that. So proceed.
Across the top of the hour, Thunder Radio Morning Show Overdrive is financed by our friends over at New Haven Mortgage in downtown Manchester. Folks, New Haven Mortgage, they do a lot of great work. They're going to help you, whether it's you're a first-time home buyer trying to get pre-qualified, or maybe you want to cash out refinance. They can do that. They are people. You can sit down, talk to them, interact with them. They're not robots. They're not overseas. They're not in another state. They can help you in any unique situation. So get on by and see Heather Phillips and her team at New Haven Mortgage, downtown Manchester, newhavenmtg.com, NMLS 1477317.
Broadcasting from the Unity Medical Center Studios, this is Thunder Radio, WMSR, 1320 AM, 107.9 FM, and worldwide.
Should play camera?
Yeah, dual camera.
Dumb Ways to Die with John's Procrastinating at the Station. We're getting show names. Dr. Carmine said you need to go live on TikTok daily. Can I go live on TikTok with the show?
All right, I'm fixing to go live.
Now, can we go live on TikTok? It does not give me an option for that right now, our software. But I'm gonna do Instagram Live is a new thing, but we can go live on Hopping. What is that? And Twitch. We don't have any of that. We'll do Wednesday's Worst Criminal next, huh?
All right, I'm fixing to go live.
No? On TikTok?
Yeah.
No, very good. Do it.
All right, I hope I don't mess up. Confirm your age before going live. What's your date of birth? Oh, my gosh.
The radio station's date of birth. Put that in. 1957. March 19th or 18th, whatever. 1957. Yeah, March 18th, 1957. That's when we were born.
Choose.
A lot harder than you thought, huh? People are going to be thrilled with this. This is going to be the content.
Confirm date of birth? How? Facial age estimation?
Oh.
I'm going back. I'm changing the age. Because if it says I look.
You ain't going to look 67. Yeah, let's give the Chinese your facial age or your face. Yeah, let's do that with TikTok. They need your face. They need I need facial recognition to confirm your age. Also, what's your bank account?
Preparing camera. Oh, place your face in the frame. Move closer.
Josh could share quotes of the day on TikTok since the family doesn't read them. That's a good idea, Brian. Maybe they'll see them there. I've started sending them to Snapchat.
Age confirmed. I must look my age.
I don't think you look your age at all.
Practice mode is available. Practice mode will only be visible to you. You will have time to explore live feature. Okay, practice now.
We go live all the time. Why do you need to practice? Maybe you should practice.
Am I videoing?
Good thing you're practicing. Hey, Laura. Holly. Let me know when
I need to go live.
Her tech skills are
go live.
About on point with her mama's.
Here I go. I'm going to do it. Hey, everybody. Yeah. We're going live. We've got Wednesday's Worst Criminal coming up next on the morning show. Stick with us. We're here Monday through Friday.
See, I'm not a big fan of going live.
6:30 to 8:30.
Good job, Holly. She knows the show schedule.
Kate is on. Kate, thank you
she
for joining.
She knows that we're about to do it. How do you, why don't you tell them how they can actually catch the show? You said stick with us, but we're not going to have them there.
Well, the folks that are watching the live, they're sticking with us on the live.
Oh, you're keeping that on.
Well, I can't, you know what? I just realized I can't keep it on because I don't have the story. Yeah, they're on my phone.
So don't stick with us. Well done.
Yeah, but you can watch us on Facebook on the Radio 107.9, 1320 AM, the Manchester Go app. We've got a live stream going on Facebook, Insta, Twitter, and look at all these people joining. Hattie.
People we already know. We need the 20.
Jeff. A lot of people are joining. Eli, this is good stuff right here. Wednesday's Worst
Criminals.
Because
they can't see what they're doing, what we're doing on this live feed.
I'm going to turn it another live video. Let me turn it around to Josh. Ready? Boosh.
It's thrilling. It's thrilling stuff. You can see your camera light.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because tell everybody, hey.
Hey, because y'all couldn't follow what we're doing live with the two camera system on Facebook or YouTube or, you know,
TikTok.
I couldn't do that.
It's where it's at. How do I stop it?
Pew, pew. Do that.
Congratulations.
Hattie said, I'm watching both. Y'all are in stereo now.
You have more comments than 50% of live creators with a similar following.
It basically is like, good job on your 2,000 followers and your 5 comments.
Ooh, this one wants to go live for 60 minutes. Oh, total. Okay. Go live on 3 separate days. I guess it's...
You get like points?
How was your live experience? I'm going to say good. Does that put that on our wall?
Probably.
I don't see it there, so good. Whatever. I don't know. I'm learning.
All right, we come back here about 5 seconds.
Studies show that 9 out of 10 Manchester residents listen to the Thunder Radio morning show. The 10th guy, he doesn't even have a radio. Thunder Radio.
Thunder Radio morning show. Overdrive financed by New Haven Mortgage. Cash out refinance. I guarantee your home has built up equity. And you can turn that cash into a new project, new building, new pool, whatever, around the house. NewHavenMTG.com. Heather Phillips and her team. Over 60 years of experience. Find them in person right here in Manchester on the square in downtown Manchester, New Haven Mortgage. Holly, welcome back.
Thank you.
All right, we've got 20 minutes or so left. And if y'all want to see some thrilling video, check out our TikTok where Holly was live during the break and making videos that were also being made over here.
I got to start making more video.
Good. Yeah.
I got to be more active.
Productivity is the name of the game that we're going for. Been the theme today. More productive. Better.
Yeah, we're going to be better, you guys.
I need to hire about 3 helpers. I don't have the budget for that. Really?
All right, we're doing Wednesday's Worst Criminal here.
Oh, I didn't have my song ready. Distract the people while I find it.
Last week, we were in Australia, so I was reading some of Australia's Worst Criminal. This week, we've hopped over to New Zealand.
No. Oh, how about that?
Well, don't play that.
I was about to play the wrong song. Good thing I caught that quick. All right.
A traveler got caught trying to smuggle a donkey. Phallus?
Oh.
Let's go with phallus. Into New Zealand. The smuggler arrived at the airport in Wellington and declared.
You got me for that at the airport once.
Declared.
They let me go.
To customs that he had food in his bag. It's just food. Officials were like, let's check that out. And they found the foot-long equine phallus, and they confiscated the illegal item.
Can't take that with you, buddy.
Why?
I don't know. They have all kind of rules about taking stuff across.
Not why did they take it from him? Why did he have it?
Who knows?
Okay, so an accidental millionaire is now in jail, gas station owner.
You say accidental millionaire?
Yeah.
Okay.
Huey Gao, age 32, fled to China
in 2009 after the bank mistakenly deposited $8 million in his bank account.
Yeah, I'd left too. I ain't giving that back. It's mine.
It took months for the opportunistic thief to be extradited, but he's now been sentenced to 4 years and 7 months in prison. I'd say if they accidentally put it there.
It's yours. We had that. We had a case like that in America too, right? Where the guy took the money and bought a lot of stuff. I'm like, oh, it's mine now.
All right, you've heard of a butt dial.
Mm-hmm.
A 58-year-old convict had his forbidden cell phone between his rear end cheeks when the guard came into the cell. That's where he hid it. And then the phone rang. The guard confiscated the cell phone. I just hope he had some latex gloves on.
Some gloves. That's some strength right there.
What's that ringing? Sorry, I had chili last night. A teacher in Malaysia forced his students to eat grass as punishment for not doing their homework.
I'm all here for it, man.
The English language teacher also made some of the lazy children wear bells around their necks to shame them. After outraged parents complained, the teacher was transferred to a school with a black top and no grass. That's sad to think that there's a school with no grass.
Right. Where do they play? I'm sure that happens, I guess, in the cities, the bigger cities, urban areas and things. So you keep your stories. I was looking up accidental deposits.
Okay.
In 2021, a bank accidentally deposited $50 billion into a Louisiana family's account.
I'm going to spend some of it.
$50 billion. I'd be like, well, can I siphon off a million of it? Like, will they notice?
We're going Sizzler that night.
So for 4 days, Darren James and his family were multi-billionaires. He's a real estate agent in Baton Rouge. He and his wife were doing a routine check of their finances on Saturday when they noticed $50 billion had been mistakenly deposited into their bank account. That's not like a 10 or 20 error that somebody fell asleep on the keyboard. I was pretty excited. It wasn't an inheritance. He thought maybe it was an inheritance that he got. Oh, maybe this is mine. It was an error. So it was restored to the correct balance by Tuesday.
Golly.
I would have been like, I'm taking a million of this. You can have it back. A million of this is mine.
So, yeah.
Half a million. Would they notice a $500,000? $500,000.
I wasn't even going to go $500,000. I was just maybe $10,000.
No. $500,000.
Maybe enough to buy a new car. I don't know. Maybe $20,000.
Have you seen car prices?
That's why I raised it a little. I said, I know what the price of other people's vehicles are, but
new car.
We've never had super expensive vehicle.
No, not that we own, not that we bought. No.
All right. This next
Wednesday's worst criminal.
Dumb criminal is this one's in Malaysia. Cattle rustlers, thieves in Malaysia, stuffed three full-size cows into a tiny Proton automobile, which is about the size of a Toyota Corolla.
You said cows?
Yep. They had taken out the back seats for more room, but they didn't get far because the cows weighed them down. They were just trying to.
Car's too heavy.
Full-size cows.
How do you fit I can't imagine one full-size cow in the back of a car.
I can't imagine
just sitting there with her head out the window. You see this thing drive by with the bumper dragging the ground? You got a little greedy there. One cow.
Yeah.
Take one cow.
We've moved over to Indonesia now. A burglar broke into an Indonesian home with the intent to steal valuables. He tied up the married couple in order to rob them. But when their hungry baby started crying, he warmed up some baby formula and fed the infant while rocking it in his arms. He eventually fled with the valuables. Police soon captured him, but the infant was put to sleep.
No.
Went to bed.
There.
Do you remember, when you're trying to get the kids to sleep, you will try almost anything. Drive them around in the car till they fall asleep. But I can remember the boy one was a little colicky, and so I really had to bounce. So I had one of those exercise balls that I would bounce and pat him. If someone broke in and put that baby to bed, I'd been like,
give them all the stuff they wanted.
Hey, appreciate you. Can you come back tomorrow?
Yeah. Now, granted, we didn't have a lot of valuables for people to take at any point in time, really. I don't know what we would have given them. Here's a 32-inch tube TV.
Authorities discovered almost 1,500 pig-nosed turtles and two pieces of baggage headed out of the country. The turtles are considered an endangered species.
How many do they have?
1,500.
How endangered can they be if you can gather up 1,500 of those? It's like, be like me, be like, I got 1,500 grasshoppers.
These turtles can grow up to 44 pounds and are a favorite of smugglers. Why, I wonder? Do they eat them?
There must be some kind of value there. But people must pay for them, or turtle soup or something. Make a lot of soup with one of those. You ever had turtle soup? Is that a thing?
Yeah, that's a thing. I've never had that, no. You can make soup out of anything.
Yeah.
This one was in Russia.
Yeah, I can't roll my tongue like that.
I got to thinking about that. When on the Red Hot Chili Peppers song, Give It Away, how do you sing that?
Give it away?
Because he says, give it away.
Give it away, give it away, give it away. There's no role. I can't do it. Stop making fun of me.
He can do it. All right, Shredder, so this happens.
Like turtle soup. True that.
A former teacher in Russia stabbed a man to death in a drunken argument about the merits of poetry versus prose. What's that? P-R-O-S-E. What's that?
I don't know.
The stabber preferred poetry.
Okay. I don't know. Our lack of culture showing here.
Can I Google what that is right fast?
Yeah, while you do, I'll just talk about how it doesn't seem like Russia would be a very fun place to visit. Like, what about Russia seems fun?
In writing, prose refers to any written work that follows a basic grammatical structure. So,
just writing?
Poetry is kind of free for all.
Yeah.
All right. Gotcha. What was your question? I'm sorry.
Oh, I was just saying, I don't know why anybody would want to live in Russia. Mm. It just doesn't seem like a very fun place. Or like, why would you want to visit there?
I feel like it's very gray.
Like, yeah, the TV shows.
The buildings are gray.
It's gray, it's dark, and it's snowy and cold all the time.
I have no idea. That's just my...
It is a 1960s TV show.
A doctor was arrested after he was called to remove 5 grams of heroin from a drug mule's stomach, but he only turned in 2 grams. Police became suspicious when they arrived to collect the drugs.
That's it.
But they found both the suspect and the doctor high and unresponsive.
Nice. Free drugs, man.
A judge was caught napping while on the bench. He was fired after he sentenced a businessman to 5 years in prison for fraud. And the defendant's attorney posted video showing the jurist sleeping on the bench. We learned that the defendant will get a new trial.
I would hope. Where's this at?
Russia.
Oh, I'm surprised anybody got a new trial in Russia. I didn't know they even had trials over there. I thought you were just guilty. You're just guilty. One more or two. Wednesday's worst criminals today.
This is... Hold on to your seats. This happened in Poland. A disturbed Warsaw woman has been taken into custody for allegedly trying to create a Frankencat. Police raided her home and found live cats and dogs and the corpses of hundreds of pets, many of which had been cut up. The home was filled with stench. The woman told the police she was trying to make an undead feline, a Frankencat.
Okay.
So.
Like she was trying to But Dahmer tried this, didn't he?
Well, sort of.
I mean, it didn't work out. He tried to keep him alive.
Yeah. He wanted them in a like a
zombie-like
state. She's trying to bring cats back from the dead.
She's killing them and trying to bring them back.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah,
hadn't worked yet, has it?
Not for her.
That's crazy. Thunder Radio Morning Show brought to you by New Haven Mortgage. Cash out refinance, a great way to take advantage of the equity in your home, or maybe you're a first-time home buyer. The rates came down recently. Good time to start looking. NewHavenMTG.com, NMLS 1477317. While we got a second, let's take a look at the weather outside and what we got coming up the next couple of days. We're already up to 40 today. We're going to get near 70 today. A nice 5 to 10 mile an hour breeze coming out of the southwest. It'll shift out of the northwest later this afternoon. Around 40 overnight tonight, so pretty chilly once the sun goes down. Mostly clear. 67 tomorrow. 48 tomorrow night, so we stay nice and warm. I thought it said 40, but no, 48 tomorrow night. Friday, a little cooler, 62, 70% chance of rain, really picking up in the afternoon into the evening. Friday night, rain chances pretty heavy, about 80%. Saturday, much cooler, 57 for your high. Sunday looks good, going to be up around 70 degrees. Weather forecast brought to you by Patton Pest Control. Spring means bugs. Call Tyler Patton today, 931-247-0781. Great thing about working with Patton Pest Control, no contracts, licensed, bonded, and insured, very affordable. He's local. He's going to come help you out. He's not going to require any contracts for your home or your business. Call Tyler Patton today, 931-247-0781.
Enjoy the morning show with Josh and Holly on the Carmine Family Dental Camera Perfect Smile Cams. Just find Thunder Radio on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube to watch.
Let's see what you on TikTok again?
Yeah.
We're going to come back for like 2 minutes, so just kind of a wrap up.
I was seeing...
Thanks for listening.
I was just wondering if I could request a song.
Sure, what do you
want to
hear?
Well, actually, I can't remember. Let me show you what a day in the life of the radio host looks like. Let's go. First things first, I live my life on a 3-snooze average.
Think you can be a radio host? Give this script a try in 20 seconds.
Huh. Yeah, let's let Holly do radio script.
What is your hidden talent that you think is... Welcome to How to Morgan Radio 101. Class is now in session, and I will be your teacher for the day. Unqualified, but happy to be here. Today, I'm going to teach you 3 ways that you can get started in radio. First, you can go to school for it. There are tons of post-secondary.
I did not recommend going to school for radio.
Check your privilege additional.
Just buy the station.
Put a finger down if you have been called a racial slur.
This is such a fucking great song.
Check your privilege addition. Put a finger down if you have been called a racial slur.
What are you watching?
Put a finger down if you've been followed in a store unnecessarily.
This is such a fucking great song.
What are you watching?
Radio show host TikToks to see what I should be doing.
Oh, okay. No original ideas here. We're going to do some copycat.
Everything is a copycat, Josh.
I'm here for it. We do a lot of copycat around here. We'll just take somebody else's stuff and make it better. That's what we do.
Me finding out my neighbor is a radio host. Me finding out my neighbor is a radio host.
I'm that way. I have a new neighbor, and all she wants to do is talk.
I'll get better.
Is that Luke Bryan?
Yeah.
I can hear that voice. No, I can't wait to see what you come up with on TikTok. I don't even know how to. I've never made a TikTok in my life. Never made one. Never posted
You've been
one.
In TikToks.
I've been in them. No, I've been in. I'm saying never produced one. I couldn't tell you how to start.
Is there a place for the lives?
I don't know. Like where they post them later, surely there is. Like where it archives it.
I don't know.
I would think.
Yeah, I'm sending the class and it kills my hair. Yeah, if y'all want to try to lose popular, y'all. Yeah, I'm sending.
That you selling ass?
It
kills my
hair. No.
Yeah, if y'all
look
want
at
to lose popular, y'all. Yeah, I'm sending the class and it kills my hair. Yeah, if y'all want to try to lose
this popular, stuff I've videoed, but not.
Never posted? I hope the TikTok Holly makes us is as entertaining as watching her try to make a TikTok earlier. Agreed.
Mortgage, your local experts in home financing with over 60 years in the industry. Equal housing lender, NMLS 1477317.
Final couple minutes of the morning show on this Wednesday. I feel like a productive show for the most part. Now, can we continue the productivity post show?
Absolutely. I'm very motivated.
Very motivated today.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
See, I'm told that motivation is good, but you got to have discipline. You can be motivated one day.
I am also very disciplined.
Are you?
Yes.
Okay.
You guys, I look forward to giving you an update tomorrow on
the things we get done today.
Our productivity, our motivation.
Yeah. Well, we'll keep you updated.
Our stamina for work. It's going to be good.
We'll be back 6:30 to 8:30 tomorrow. Before we get out of here, I want to tell you about the Mercantile Cafe, Bakery, and Gift Shop. We're down on Cook and Meet Southern Hospitality. So they're really focusing on their breakfast. They start serving at 7 a.m. Wednesday through Friday at the Mercantile. So $5, you can get plates piled high with your breakfast favorites. They got biscuits. They got cinnamon rolls. They got quiches over there. And they got good coffee and mixed drinks as well. I didn't mean alcohol. I mean, like, that's probably the wrong word there. Like, cappuccinos and stuff. Fancy drinks. That's what I meant. So get on by and see them for breakfast. 210 Woodbury Highway. They start serving at 7 a.m. Today for lunch, they'll cook that up 11 until 2. Cafeteria style at the Mercantile. Today's menu, they've got country fried steak or chicken and dressing. On the sides, mashed potatoes, cream corn, green beans, broccoli and cheese, pinto beans, mixed greens, coleslaw, broccoli salad, cornbread salad, blueberry or pistachio congealed salad. Meat and 2 or meat and 3, your choice. They got soup today. They got chili. Hey! There's my chili. Had chili Monday. Had chili Tuesday. I'm going to try to do chili every day this week.
Pray for me.
Cleanse out the system, you know? Cleanse out the system. 210 Woodbury, or 210 North Irwin Street, excuse me. They're right there across from Manchester Police Department. Big gray block building. Can't miss them. They'll be there for dinner tonight as well. Wednesday through Friday, lunch and dinner. Saturdays and Sundays, lunch is 11 until 2. Go by and see them at the Merc. We're done today. Catch replays of the show on Apple, Spotify, or Google for you audio side of things. Search for The Morning Show with Josh and Holly. Join our tens of subscribers. I remembered to actually record the show today, so you'll get to hear the whole show. And then you can watch the video archives of the show on our Facebook and our Twitter. Just search for Thunder Radio, or YouTube as well. Search for Thunder Radio. Give us a like or subscribe there. Swap a Chop coming up next. Got some music at 9. Rick and Bubba at 10. Dan Bongino at 12. Connected Coffee County with Tiffany at 3. Talk to y'all tomorrow. We'll try to do better then.